We all make mistakes, but rarely do our oversights cost us our life savings. The monumental events that you're about to see not only endangered lives, tore down construction, and made news headlines around the world, but they cost shareholders, taxpayers, buyers, and builders hundreds of thousands, sometimes millions, and yes, sometimes billions of dollars. Next time, these people will think twice before signing on the dotted line and agreeing to something with underlying fatal flaws. It all comes down to proper planning, or in these cases, a significant lack thereof. In case you were ever thinking of constructing a dam, here's a hot tip. Stay away from wetlands. The soft ground allows for the unevening and changing of weight distributions, and it's for this reason that engineers avoid using wetlands as foundations. Well, most engineers. In places like the USA, China, and Switzerland, engineers have overlooked the challenges of building dams on shaky ground and done so anyway, getting away with it. For now. In Brazil, though, they learned the hard way why careful dam planning is essential. Check it out. On January 25th, 2019, the Brumadinho Dam collapsed after parts of the sand and dried mud structure dissolved into liquid. It wasn't just water stored in this dam. It was mixed with waste, creating a giant wave of nearly 12 million cubic meters of toxic mud. The company behind the dam, Vale, paid about $107 million in compensation to the workers affected by the deadly dam rupture. That's on top of the millions of dollars worth of damage to the area, a giant cost for a mistake that could easily have been avoided. What would happen if, say, the infamous Hoover Dam broke? Once we had our catalyst, be that an explosion, earthquake, or human error, 9 trillion gallons of water would be set loose, covering an area of 10 million acres. That's bigger than the entire state of New Jersey. A massive water spill is one thing, but an oil spill takes it to another level. The Deepwater Horizon oil spill, known as the BP oil spill, is considered the largest, most dangerous, and most expensive oil disaster in modern times. About 41 miles off the coast of Louisiana, the Deepwater Horizon drilling rig exploded. But how? The answer? Oversight. And natural gas. The core of the rig was weak. It wasn't built to handle immense pressure blasting. So, when natural gas was pressure blasted in order to seal the well, it cracked the core, allowing the natural gas to ascend to the deep water rig's surface platform, where it ignited, causing the entire rig to sink. The volume of escaping oil, according to U.S. government officials, peaked at more than 60,000 barrels per day, totaling more than 210 million gallons, threatening marine life and wildlife habitats all the way from Louisiana to Florida. It took months to stop the flow. What was the cost of such a glaring mistake? Taking cleaning, legal fees, and fines into account, close to $61 billion. Is anybody here old enough to remember the Challenger disaster? That was one heck of a costly error. We'll explain. The date was January 28, 1986, and NASA's shuttle was ready to be propelled for its final flight, with the objective of deploying satellites and recording scientific data. Just 73 seconds after liftoff, the Challenger disintegrated in midair over the Atlantic Ocean, off the coast of Cape Canaveral in Florida. But what the team didn't know was that the frosty temperatures from the night before had frozen rubber parts in the rocket boosters. The space shuttle had never been tested at temperatures that cold, an oversight that would prove not only pricey, with a cost to the nation of $3.2 billion, but deadly. While the incident was under investigation and while the entire blueprints were undergoing engineer redesigns, NASA's space shuttle fleet was grounded for almost 3 years. Do we have any Bitcoin fans in the house? For those well-versed in cryptocurrency, you're already aware of the severe risks of ownership. We're not referring to the volatility of the value, we're referring to the inevitability of forgetting your password. There's no bank teller, there's no way to reset your password. If you forget your credentials, your money is gone forever. It's happened to hundreds of thousands of people around the globe, many of which are sitting on million-dollar fortunes that they'll never be able to access. James Howells from Britain is a perfect unfortunate example of this. James started buying Bitcoin in 2009 when it was practically worthless. To give you an idea, in March of 2010, one Bitcoin was worth $0.003. James owned 7,500 Bitcoins. In today's value, that's over $65 million. James had his data stored on his personal laptop, which stopped working one day, but he kept the hard drive, thereby keeping the information accessible for a later date. But tragically, one disastrous day in 2013, he mistakenly put that drive in the trash. He lobbied with the council for years, hoping to search landfill for his lost Bitcoin, but with no luck. The moral of the story? Right write down your passwords in two places? In March of 2011, a disastrous 9.0 undersea earthquake off the coast of Japan wreaked havoc in the Pacific. It slingshotted a tsunami more than 130 feet high in all directions, causing immense damage to any landmass it crossed. However, as damaging as the tsunami was, it wasn't the event that proved to be the most costly. It was the preceding nuclear meltdown. A significant oversight at the Fukushima Daiichi nuclear power plant made it especially vulnerable. The impact of the tsunami caused the plant's backup generator to shut down. Without the backup generator, the regular nuclear cooling process couldn't take place, creating a chain reaction, causing three nuclear reactors to melt down and hydrogen explosions to release dangerous radiation into the air, prompting a hasty evacuation. Studies that were conducted after the fact showcased that the guidelines for the plant's necessary maintenance had been ignored. The nuclear meltdown was entirely preventable if thorough and regular checks were carried out. Unfortunately, it was that lack of foresight to account for potential threats that gave this power plant worldwide notoriety, as well as a destruction bill of $12 billion. You've all heard of Steve Jobs, the mastermind behind Apple. His partner Steve Wozniak, while lesser known, also became a household name in the tech industry. But did you know that there was a third founder? That's right, his name was Ron Wayne, and he made one of the most regrettable investing errors that the stock market has ever seen. Apple was founded in 1976, when it was but a sliver of the international conglomerate it's become today. In that same year, Ron Wayne decided he wanted out. He asked to cash out his 10% share of Apple, and Steve Jobs obliged. These days, if he still held that 10% share of what has become a $1.3 trillion company, he'd have a bank balance of well over $100 billion. You know how much he sold his shares for back in 1976? $800.
Incredibly generous golden parachutes. The same opportunity as detailed inside that envelope.
If you thought that the Fukushima nuclear disaster was tragic and expensive, well, it was, but it pales when compared to the Chernobyl catastrophe of Saturday, April 26th, 1986. At an almost incomprehensible monetary loss of $590 billion, the Chernobyl disaster is hands down the worst, deadliest, and most expensive nuclear accident of all time. Sadly, like many other events we've already seen, it was entirely preventable. It all started when a power outage initiated a domino effect of events. Eventually leading to a mass evacuation of the city of Pripyat due to radiation contaminating the air, soil, and everything it came into contact with. To this day, it's known as the exclusion zone. Had crucial design flaws been fixed before the plant was built, the reactor causing the terrible incident may not have exploded. Even early into the 21st century, between 5 and 7% of government spending in Ukraine was still related to Chernobyl. It wasn't one mistake and one paycheck to fix it. It was a mistake with effects that will last for tens, if not hundreds, of years. We all know where Alaska is, but did you know that it actually once belonged to Russia? That's right. Up until 1867, Alaska was on Russian soil, and it was a great resource for them, providing plenty of fur, tea, and of course, ice. Although, in the aftermath of the Crimean War, Emperor Alexander II of Russia began exploring the possibility of selling it. Why? Because he saw no more value. The land was too far from mainland Russia, allowing for invasion and takeover threats, and it was mighty cold, making farming difficult. Russia sold it to the States for $7,200,000. However, just 29 years later, in 1869, Americans struck gold in the Yukon. That paved the way for further resource discovery like oil. All in all, the Americans made their money back more than 100 times over, while the Russians looked on with regret at the literal gold mine that they'd just given up. Next up, the most famous ill-fated ship of all time, the RMS Titanic. We're aware that it hit an iceberg. Although unknown to most, there was another factor at play, one which could have been avoided. Fires had been burning out of control in the engine room in the days leading up to the maiden voyage. These fires, which were mostly ignored, weakened the single-sheet hull. For comparison, most modern ships are double-layered. Had it not been for the iceberg hitting the exterior of the same area where the fires were burning, the hull may not have been breached, potentially saving over 1,500 lives. It was one of the most costly blunders in history. The boat itself, in 1912, cost $7.5 million, roughly $180 million today. Legal fees rocketed the total expenditure far, far higher. We've actually got an entire video about the real reason the Titanic sank. Link is in the description. Check it out. China is always developing new and improved apartment buildings. But unfortunately, back on June 27th, 2009, one of those buildings didn't go quite as planned. 11 buildings, each 13 stories high, had been constructed in a residential complex in the Minhang district of Shanghai, which is right about here. One of those buildings, without notice, collapsed, causing a stir in the media and a huge headache for the construction company. But how on earth does a building like this come tumbling down? Actually, earth is the reason. In order to build a garage under the soon-to-be rubble building, excavators had to remove large quantities of earth, dumping it carelessly in a landfill nearby. The weight of that discarded earth caused the adjacent riverbank to collapse, causing the water to flow out and seep into the ground underneath the building. With the foundation quickly turning to mud, the apartment building had no hope. If they had put more thought into the way they disposed of the dug-up earth, that building would still be standing, and a multi-million-dollar disaster would have been...